Steven, they made it seem like your house arrest has kind of been like this walk in the park. Like you've been able to come and go as you please. I mean, I was just there. It doesn't seem that way. There seems to be a personal disdain the judge has for you in basically describing it like you have not really suffered here.
Do you want to answer that?
She compared it to the pandemic and that you were just...
Let me just address that briefly. It is certainly been true that the probation department has permitted Stephen to spend time with his young son, provided there's advance notice and provided things are worked out properly. And that's a true thing. The rest of the time, however, he has been prohibited from engaging in normal human activities that are an indispensable part of liberty. To walk down the street, to simply go to a park and sit there in the park, to show up at a demonstration. In one case, he wasn't even permitted to leave his home, to walk downstairs and walk across the street to address demonstrators who were there in his support. This 2 years of detention has essentially incapacitated Stephen as a human rights advocate, which frequently involves traveling to places for meetings, for conferences, meeting with affected and frontline and indigenous communities. And it has prevented all of that. These remain, I mean, home detention with an ankle monitoring device is the most serious imposition on liberty short of actual incarceration itself. It's written there in the bail statute. So the fact that she's allowed him to go to a ball game with his son is lovely, but it's been 2 years of this.
In the 145-page indictment over the summer, she said it was time for you to pay the piper. I read it. It really reeked of like some personal animosity towards you. And then today, it seemed like she had been working on this for a long time. Like this was not something she just decided in the recent week. The key thing that stood out to me is she was reading from the appellate decision to prop up this claim that you had paid off an Ecuadorian judge, but she kind of left out key details like, Mr. Waters said that they had rehearsed that one witness 53 times, they paid for his family to come over, that Judge Kaplan himself had ties to Chevron. It just seems like there's a lot of personal animosity here that I've never heard in a misdemeanor before.
Well, there is a lot of personal animosity by Judge Prescott and Judge Kaplan and Chevron. I mean, they're angry that I think they're angry for various reasons. Fundamentally, that I help indigenous peoples hold a large American company accountable for massive environmental crimes in the Amazon. I mean, they don't want an American lawyer, particularly one from their world, who went to Harvard Law School, doing that kind of work. They're angry. You know, they're almost angrier at me than if I had actually taken a pickaxe and murdered 10 people. I mean, I really feel that. They're really angry at me. And I think it's ideologically driven, and I think they're abusing their power, you know. So this treatment of me is totally disparate. You know, 787 days on house arrest for an offense where the longest sentence ever given is 90 days is disparate. It's discriminatory. It's selective, and it's wrong. So, you know, what she attempted to do today was justify these abuses of power by clothing them in technical jargon and making it look like there was some legitimate legal reason to do this, and we reject that.
And do you think on the wider scale, you look at what happened at Standing Rock, what's been going on at Line 3, basically trying to criminalize environmental activism and now, you know, legal activism. There's been laws attempted in states to criminalize or let people off if they run over protesters. All of this is happening under, you know, a Democratic administration. What are your thoughts on the role of Merrick Garland, Joe Biden, who said a lot about Trump's attacks on the law?
Well, I think the Biden administration, I'm sorry, in the Department of Justice need to step in and take back the prosecution from the private Chevron law firm and conduct it professionally, responsibly, consistent with legal ethics and the rule of law. They haven't done that. You know, they're weaponizing the law to attack an activist, which, as you know, is part of a trend in the United States, not to leak and speak to that. It's happening in my case. This is a significant, even egregious illustration of that trend, which has now begun to really penetrate our legal system in ways that, frankly, should terrify anyone who believes in the rule of law and free speech in our country. Because our country is under serious threat from corporate control of our courts and our laws that punish the heck out of people who take on the fossil fuel industry. And I'm part of that. That's why this is happening to me fundamentally.